Welcome to our service of Compline this Tuesday, the 30th of August. I'm Reverend Carole with the Kingsbury and Baxterley Group of Parishes. Today we will be celebrating John Bunyan, a famous spiritual writer who wrote The Pilgrim's Progress. If you haven't read it, then do. It's a really good book. So, a bit of information about John Bunyan. My book says, born at Elstow in Bedfordshire in 1628, John Bunyan was largely self-educated and used the Bible as his grammar. He read very few other books, and they were all piously Protestant in nature. Yet he produced Pilgrim's Progress, probably the most original text of spiritual genius that century, telling the story of the man Christian on his journey through life to God. It was not written while he was a prisoner in Bedford jail, as often stated, but during a confinement some years later. History tells us little of the man, but what is clear from his writings is that the salvation of the soul was what mattered most to him. He died on this day in 1688. So that's a little bit about John Bunyan, spiritual writer. So in the usual way, let us take a moment of silence as I attempt to share my screen. The words you see in bold are for you to join in with should you wish to do so. If not, just listen and enjoy. There we go. So that's John Bunyan on the left, and a picture of the book Pilgrim's Progress. Let us begin. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. We take a moment of quiet as we reflect on the past day, the past week, and bring our concerns to God. And we say together, most merciful God, we confess to you, before the whole company of heaven and one another, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins, heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Alleluia. And we listen to Voces 8 and their version of Te Lucis Ante Terminum. This is their festal version. Our psalm this evening is Psalm 143. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and in your faithfulness give ear to my supplications. Answer me in your righteousness. Enter not into judgment with your servant, for in your sight shall no one living be justified. For the enemy has pursued me, crushing my life to the ground, making me sit in darkness like those long dead. My spirit faints within me. My heart within me is desolate. I remember the time past. I muse upon all your deeds. I consider the works of your hands. I stretch out my hands to you. My soul gasps for you like a thirsty land. O Lord, make haste to answer me. My spirit fails me. Hide not your face from me, lest I be like those who go down to the pit. Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for in you I put my trust. Show me the way I should walk in, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies, for I flee to you for refuge. Teach me to do what pleases you, for you are my God. Let your kindly spirit lead me on a level path. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake. For your righteousness' sake, bring me out of trouble. In your faithfulness, slay my enemies and destroy all the adversaries of my soul. For truly, I am your servant. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. That our scripture reading this evening comes from the Gospel of St. Matthew, from chapter 11, verses 28 to the end. Jesus said, "Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, Lord God of truth. I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me under the shadow of your wings. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. This is Voces 8 and their version of the Nunc Dimittis. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. In love and concern for all people, let us pray. To the Lord. Keep the Church constant in the humility of the service to which she is called. Bless her ministers as they work to spread the good news of salvation to all. Be merciful to the world where many are possessed by pride and made arrogant by power. Grant that those who have authority may exercise it with equal regard for the dignity of all whom they govern. Bless our homes and make them places of welcome. Keep us from becoming narrow in our hospitality and help us to look beyond those who are nearest to us. This week, we pray especially for those who live or work in the hawthorns and the larches. Actually, no, in Birchclose and Bodymore Heath Road in Kingsbury, Knoll Hill in Hurley, Edge Hill in Woodend, and the Common in Merivale with Bentley. We pray for all who are slighted and ignored because of their poverty, their disability, or their personal problems. Fill our community with love for the needy and concern for the common good. And we lift to you, Lord, all those who have asked for our prayers at this time. We pray for the departed who have come to the kingdom where all are made equal through grace, including Dick Berry, Gerald Leedham, Gary Alton, Mary Rutter, Marilyn Barnett, Chris Wathers, and Leslie Edge. Help us so to live in this world that we may be worthy at last to receive with them the blessing of eternal life. May our prayers be accepted through Christ, the Lord of the humble and meek. Amen. And we pray the collect for John Bunyan. God of peace, who called your servant John Bunyan to be valiant for truth, grant that as strangers and pilgrims, we may at the last rejoice with all Christian people in your heavenly city. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. In peace we will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. Come with the dawning of the day and make yourself known in the breaking of the bread. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give us peace. Amen. And that concludes our service of Compline this Tuesday, the 30th of August. I wish you all a peaceful, quiet, and safe night, and look forward to seeing you again next week. In the meantime, God bless.